So the term monsoon derived from the Arabic word mosin, which means seasons, changes in a seasons. So monsoons makes the break in between our summers and winters. So assumptions associated with the monsoons in India. When monsoons are arriving in India, which is known as the southwest monsoon winds, we have to assume the meteorologists, they are assuming as a sum of the aspects. First, as the shifting of a ITCZ. Yesterday, we discussed regarding as a seven pressure belts, 0 degree equatorial low pressure belt. 0 degree as an equatorial low pressure belt, which is a dynamic in nature. It is a dynamic in nature. It is not as a static, it has movable. Only as a that part, which is moving from 0 to 5 degree northern and southern hemisphere, that narrow zone is known as the ITCZ, intertropical convergence zone. This is not static, this is a dynamic in nature. As per the movement of the Earth's rotation and revolution, it is shifting from a 0 to 5 degree north and 5 degrees south. When the high temperature recorded during as the summer solstice, when sunrays are fall vertical over 23.5 degree north, under that state, ITCs are shifted towards the northern hemisphere. Till 5 degrees, it shifted towards the northern hemisphere. In a state of a winter solstice, when sunrays are may fall vertical over a Tropic of Capricorn. In that state, the ITCZ shifted towards the southern hemisphere. That's why we call ITCZ or equatorial low pressure belt is a dynamic in nature. This is not stable. This is as shifted as rotation and revolution of the Earth. Rotation and revolution of the Earth. Second assumption in relation to. First assumption is a northernmost position of the ITCZ in summers. During as a summers, when the sunrays are fall vertical over the Tropic of Cancer. This is a day as a 21st of June, when sunrays are fall vertical over Tropic of Cancer, ITCZ shifted 5 degree northern side. In that time, India has experienced the northern plains of India experienced the summers. Summers are experiencing in parts of India, in northern plains of India. First assumption. Second assumption. When the summer solstice state has occurred in India, in the great plains of India, in that time, North Tibetan Plateau, north of the Himalayas, Tibetan Plateau is there, which is known as Roof of the World. It is known as Roof of the World. The Roof of the World, at that time, Tibet Plateau has experienced the intense heat. Because of the sunrays are called vertical over the Tropic of Cancer, as their height of a Tibet plateau from mean sea level, it has receiving as a more heat. It has receiving as the more heat. So when the summer solstice has prevailed in a northern hemisphere, more heat has receiving on a Tibet plateau. Heat receiving on a Tibet plateau. Heat receiving on a Tibet plateau. Due to as a more heat receiving on a Tibet, during as the summers, low pressure developing over a Tibet plateau attract the winds. These winds are blowing from the south towards northward. Winds are blowing from south towards the northward. Sea breezes. Indian Ocean to the Great Plains of India, winds are starts to move from south towards the northward. Winds are moving from south towards the northward under influence of a low atmospheric pressure developing over a Tibet plateau. In the same time, high pressure developing over a Indian Ocean, winds are moving from south towards the northward. South towards the northward. Clear? This season is generally known as an advancing monsoon season. Second assumption, when during the summers, Tibet experienced the high temperature, Tibet receiving as the high temperature, due to as the high temperature, low atmospheric pressure prevailing over Indian subcontinent, which attracts the winds moving from a south towards northward. This is as a second assumption, which is responsible for the bringing the moisture gaining winds and cause the rain in India. Third assumption, in relation to the Indian monsoons, as the movement of the westerly jets. As we learned earlier, jet streams are fast moving winds, which are blowing in a stratosphere. Which leads as the rain in India. That rain has generally recorded at the time of January and before of monsoons. In January, such rain is known as a western disturbances, and before of the monsoons is known as a pre-monsoons. That rain which has recorded in a plains of India during the months of April and May, which is disastrous for the wheat harvesting. So that rain has receiving in India. So the movement of a westerly jet to the north of the Himalayas and the presence of the tropical easterly jet over the Indian Peninsula during the summers. It makes possibilities the movement of the winds from a south towards northward. This is also the third assumption in related to the traditional concept of monsoons, the mechanism of Indian monsoons. Fourth is the heat low around the Arabian Sea caused due to the intensive heating during the pre-monsoon months. Monsoons arriving in India in the month of June, before of the June, intense heat has experiencing over the Arabian Sea. It's due to the trade winds. Intense heat it experiencing over the Arabian Sea. So winds are moving from Indian Ocean towards the Arabian Sea. It has generally occurred before of the monsoons. During the summers, pre-monsoonal winds. These are known as a pre-monsoonal winds, which are cause as a rain in a western margins of a country, western parts of India. Gujarat, Rajasthan, and the southwestern parts of Punjab receiving as a rain through the such winds which are moving from Indian Ocean towards as Arabian Sea and cause the rain in western parts of country. Clear? Then fifth assumption in relation to the Indian monsoons as the intensity and the position of the high pressure. High pressure areas over Indian Ocean affects the Indian monsoons. It affects the Indian monsoons. This was as the traditional concept of monsoons. In relation to the monsoons, till there any questions? Till there any questions? These were as assumptions. Diagram, yesterday we discussed in a class. Tibet located at a high altitude. Under that state, Tibet has intensely heated up. Due to as a high heat, more heat receiving on a Tibet, it experiences a low atmospheric pressure. Winds moving from the south Indian Ocean towards the Tibet, which are caused as a rain. Which when winds are moving, they will gain as a moisture from the water bodies and cause the rain in a, those areas where these winds are obstructed by the relief. These winds are attracted towards the Tibet, but due to the Himalayas, they are caused the rain in a parts of India, neither in a Tibet and China. Clear? Second assumption, IT says that it is a dynamic in nature, which has a shifted 0 to 5 degree north and 5 degrees south. 0 to 5 degree north and 5 degrees south. Why? Because due to as a thermal variations. Earth is what? It's not as a vertically situated. It is a tilted in a 66 and a half degree. In that state of a 66 and a half degree, Earth rotates and revolves around the sun. Rotates around its axis, revolves around the sun. So in that state, when a northern hemisphere, sun is there, when a northern hemisphere, it has tilted in front of the sun, northern hemisphere will experience as a more heat. In that state, IT sees a shift towards a north pole. In other position, sun is there, object is there, sun, and this will be as a tilt of the earth, southern hemisphere tilted in front of the sun. In that state, the southern hemisphere will experience as a more heat. Then the ITCZ will shift towards the southern hemisphere. That's why we call ITCZ the equatorial low pressure belt is dynamic in nature. This is not permanent. It is dynamic in nature. It changes as per the thermal variations. The temperature variations are prevails in a earth. Clear, Jyoti? Westerly jet streams. Westerly jet streams are originated in a stratosphere. Generally, these winds are originated from a Mediterranean Sea. Mediterranean Sea towards the east, they are blowing. Due to the landmass of India, these are bifurcated into two parts. These winds are bifurcated, divided into two parts. One branch enters in a parts of a China, cause a rain. Another branch enters in a plains of India, which cause the rain in a month of a January. In January, these winds are known as a western disturbances. In month of April and May, they are known as a Kal Baisakhi or pre-monsoons. Kal Baisakhi, which is as a disastrous for the wheat production. Clear? This was as a traditional concept in relation to the monsoons. Now, as a modern concept. Modern concept of monsoons has influenced by the El Nino. El Nino and Southern Oscillation. El Nino and Southern Oscillation. ELNINO. El Nino and Southern Oscillation. El Nino and Southern Oscillation. The influence of Indian monsoons in relation to the El Nino and Southern Oscillation. This was also a concept which related to the Indian monsoons. It was also related to the Indian monsoons. Because till that time, cold winds moving from with the cold ocean currents from pole towards the equator world. Warmer ocean currents, when they are prevailing from equator towards polewards, they brought the hot winds moving. So what type of the winds, which where they are originate and causes a rain in India, for which as a true or a particular concept has still not present. So a recent study which revealed that the monsoons, seems to be a link between the meteorological events which are separated by, these are separated by long distances and large intervals of time. They are called as a meteorological teleconnections. Meteorological teleconnections. The one which has aroused considerable interest among the meteorologists is the difference between the El Nino and the Southern Oscillation. What it means as a El Nino, E-L-N-I-N-O, El Nino is a narrow warm current. El Nino is a narrow warm ocean current which appears off the coast of Peru. Peru has located in a South America. Peru in December. In Spanish, this is as a Spanish word. El Nino is a Spanish word which means the child Christ. C-H-I-L-D, child Christ. C-H-I-L-D, child Christ, because it appears around the Christmas. It appears around the Christmas. In some of the years, this warm Peruvian current, this is also known as a Peruvian current, that warm ocean current is also known as the Peruvian current, P-E-R-U-V-I-A-N. Peruvian current is more intense than usual. Meteorologists, they study about the 100 years of Indian monsoons. 100 monsoon years. 100 years of Indian monsoons, in which they predicted that the winds when they are moving from a Pacific Ocean to the Indian Ocean, Pacific Ocean to Indian Ocean, it leads as a rain in a next year. Next year, that El Nino concept has occurred 1 year prior to the monsoons. Means that monsoonal rain, which will be recorded in 2022 in India, month of June, their impact, their process has begins in 2021. Now, presently has a going on. Their result, it will be appear in a form of the monsoons. In relation to this, as the two conditions are marked, if high pressure developing over a Pacific Ocean, South Pacific Ocean, high pressure developing over the South Pacific Ocean, and meanwhile as a low pressure over Indian Ocean, then winds will move from Pacific to the Indian Ocean and cause rain in the next month of June. Next year of June. But as their opposite, if the high pressure developing over the Southeastern Asian countries and a low pressure over a Pacific Ocean, then the reverse order of winds will move from a Indian Ocean towards the Pacific Ocean. In such years, India receives as a low rainfall. India is generally receiving as a low rainfall during the such monsoonal years. Aapne suna hoga, monsoon, when monsoons are arriving in India as before of time or delay in time. This year, 2021, monsoons are delayed. They are delayed to the 16 days. As per their predicted time, they are delayed over 16 days. Monsoons are delayed for 16 days presently. 16 days as per the normal condition. As per the normal conditions, they are lesser comparatively the other years. So if the rain has lesser recorded in India, it will be the adversely impact over the economy. Because our economy has the based upon agriculture. If agriculture not occur good, not produce as a good production, then in such years, agriculture has faced the failure of crops. Failure of crops. जब monsoons time से पहले आ जाएं या time के बाद में आएं. Predicted time is of first 10 days of June. They are arriving over Kerala and after 40-50 days in between, they are approaching towards the Punjab. They are approaching towards the Punjab. Clear? So let's continue the El Nino. El Nino is Christ. Child Christ. That warm ocean current, Peruvian current blowing in a, it is blowing or sorry, it is flowing along western coastal plains of South America, western coastal plains of South America and influences the Indian monsoons. It influences the Indian monsoons. It reveals when the surface temperature goes up in the South Pacific Ocean, India receives the deficit rainfall. Means when has the low atmospheric pressure developing due to the high temperature received on a South Pacific Ocean. High temperature, low atmospheric pressure. As they are opposite the Southeastern Asian countries, they are experiencing as the low temperature and high pressure. Winds will move from the Indian Ocean towards the Pacific Ocean as abnormal monsoon year. Abnormal monsoon year. So there had been some years during the El Nino phenomena did not occur, but India still got deficit rainfall, and conversely, India still got the deficit rainfall and conversely, India received the sufficient rainfall during the El Nino years. In that state, when the high pressure developing over Pacific Ocean leads movement of winds from a Pacific Ocean towards the Indian Ocean. Such years are the normal monsoon years. When the rain has recorded as the normal in that state, when high pressure developing over South Pacific Ocean and low pressure over South Indian Ocean, winds moving from the Pacific to the Indian Ocean. Yes, very good. El Nino effect has apt when the high pressure developing over a Pacific Ocean. El Nino effect is active when the high pressure developing over a Pacific Ocean, neither in Indian Ocean. Clear, Dhiren? Indian Ocean experience as the low atmospheric pressure. Winds comes from a Pacific to the Indian Ocean and cause as a normal rainfall. Isika opposite, when the high pressure has developing over a Southeastern Asian countries, means parts of Indian Ocean, and the low pressure, comparatively Indian Ocean, low pressure developing over a Pacific Ocean, winds will move from a Indian Ocean towards the Pacific Ocean. This is also the El Nino phenomena, but these are the abnormal monsoon year. Out of the 100 years of a monsoonal study of India, 43 years out of the 100 were there in which as India received as a low as compared to their average rainfall. India has the monsoonal type of climate which experienced as the 80 to 100 centimeters annually rainfall. 80 to 100 centimeters annual rainfall recorded in India as an average. Some areas are there in the northeastern states which are receiving as more than 1,000 centimeters annual rainfall. But as they compare western sides of our country, third is receiving as a less than 20 centimeters rainfall. Central India, parts of Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Central Maharashtra, Telangana, Karnataka, they are receiving as a 60 centimeters. So as in totality, India is receiving as 80 to 100 centimeters annual rainfall. 80 to 100 centimeters annual rainfall, which has impacted by the temperature conditions prevailing in between our Pacific to the Indian Ocean. If the high pressure developing over Indian Pacific Ocean and low pressure over Indian Ocean, then the winds will move from Pacific to Indian Ocean. Normal year. Abnormal year of monsoons, when high pressure developing over the Indian Ocean, low pressure as comparatively in Pacific areas, in Pacific Ocean, then the winds will move from Indian Ocean towards Pacific Ocean and cause as a low rainfall. Clear? This will cause as a low rainfall or abnormal year of monsoons. So this much for today. That's where we will continue in our next class. So any questions?